We're talking to boxing trainer Henry Ramirez. Look at this table, Henry.
What up? Canelo and boxing trainer plan, bro.
Okay, what's your prediction?
Plan by knockout.
That Andre Ward said that. What was he thinking?
So, honestly, Ellie, I think Plant's gonna start well. I think the first four or five rounds will give Canelo some problems. I think 6, 7, 8, Canelo takes over. I predict a 9th or 10th round stoppage.
That's what he said. He said 7 or 9.
It's kind of the consensus.
Why do you say Canelo stops Plant?
Canelo's just on another level, Ellie. He's seen every style. Left, right, he's a guy who we think like, damn, he's ascending to the top fighter in the world, right? But he looks better and better every fight, you know? He finds a new way to beat you. Some days he'll unbox you, then he'll come get you. Canelo's a bad dude, bro. Gotta give him that credit.
I want to tell everybody that's watching, they're going to see you in a pay-per-view. You have the fighter, you're training, the co-main event. Tell us about it.
Where's the co-main event?
Who's fighting?
I have Marco Fernandez, who's, I know a lot of people are complaining about the undercard. People can complain, but it's an opportunity for one of my fighters, great opportunity. He's fighting Anthony Durrell in the co-main event. Well prepared, bro. Durrell's been talking a lot about retirement. We're going to try to send him there on Saturday,
What makes Fernandez so good? He had a major upset.
Hey, he had a major upset. Labor Day weekend on Fox. You know what's funny, Ellie? I had a lot of people texting me that night. You were one of the ones that called me. Hey, bro, congrats. The guy did good.
It was a big deal.
It was a big deal, right? The other guy was trained by Ismael Salas, who 2 weeks before was in the corner of Ugas beating Pacquiao. And now a month later, I'm fighting Durrell, whose trainer is Sugar Hill, who a month ago, Fury would be
maybe wild, history right? Repeats itself.
We're going to try it. We're going to do it, bro.
By the way, Henry, you mentioned Sugar Hill. Jake Paul against Tommy Fury.
I've never seen Tommy Fury fight, bro. I just know he's Tyson Fury's half-brother, right?
He looks nothing like him.
I don't know. Good-looking cat. But I've never seen a fight, Ellie. I don't know anything about his boxing credentials.
Well, he's fought guys 0-26, 10 wins, 120 losses.
I'm not going to lie, bro. Look, the Paul brothers are... They're good. I mean, I know people have their opinions, good or bad, but the more eyes on the sport, it's a little better.
By the way, I'm very disappointed that Rollies is not fighting Tank. Someone says an allegation. It's not a charge. It's not an arrest. It's not
you're
a.
Right, you're
he's
right,
not but, guilty.
But let me give you an example. So the Dodgers had a pretty frontline pitcher suspended this year, Trevor Bauer, right?
Amazing player.
He was suspended for allegations. Yeah, he was investigated, but really nothing came out. And the chick was kind of a whore. She was admitting to her text messages that she sent to her friends came out. And it really made you scratch your head like, wait, what's her motive here?
Money.
Yeah, but I don't know. Listen, Ellie, I'm a little sensitive to the matter because I have a 23-year-old daughter. Somebody does that to my daughter, right?
But let me say the other side of it. Every fighter could be a victim of extortion.
True.
Pay me money or you're not fighting. I'm going to say you were inappropriate. Exactly. We live in a witch hunt era. Me too.
It is true.
That's not, no. Guilty, innocent, until proven guilty. Not guilty until proven innocent.
It's true, but you just had to know with Showtime, being with CBS.
How do you know this girl's not imagining it?
We don't know.
There's two or three sides to the story.
None of us were there. But... the reality is, Ellie, look at a couple of years ago,